Hi, it's Karin Lanning from the YMCA of Greater Michiana, coming to you from the O'Brien Center. And I'm in the Bendix room specifically, where I do yoga on Fridays. So would love to have you join me in person if you're ready for that. But if not, I'll keep giving you some Sunday morning yoga. If you want to have a rolled up towel to utilize for blocks, if you have those at home, anything that might help you just find a comfortable position as we work, I'll give some cues to tell you when you might want those. And if you don't, that's okay. I won't be using them myself, but we want to just make sure this feels great for our bodies. So go ahead and join me on the mat. And we're going to come into child's pose. So just ease your body down to that mat. Bending the knees, come into forward fold. And as we get started, just take the knees wherever you need them so that you're comfortable. If you have a block and you'd like to use it, you could set it underneath those sits bones to rest. And then we're going to ease the body forward. Nice and slow. Walking those hands forward. So maybe you rest on the forearms, or if it feels comfortable, you might bring those hands forward and let the forehead start to rest towards the floor. So if you have two blocks, you might rest your forehead on that second block. Our goal here is just to relax and set an intention for the class. So breathe it in and exhale. What are you feeling right now? Our goal is to find whatever we need today. That might be stress relief. It might be stretching of a certain area. It's just a simple positive to start the day with. This is your time. Let's take one more deep breath in. And exhale, let those hips sink. And on the next inhale, reach that right arm up high. And then exhale, thread that arm underneath the left, setting the back of the hand down and the shoulder, and maybe even the ear. This is a nice big shoulder stretch while we continue to get our hips loosen and ready for the work ahead. Let those hips soften towards the floor. Let the shoulders relax. Really feel that right shoulder getting a beautiful stretch here. And this time, with that next inhale, reach that right arm all the way up. On exhale, placing it down. Let's come to the other side. Inhale, big reach up. You might just stretch a little bit more if that feels good. And then exhale, threading the needle, resting the elbow, shoulder, and ear to the floor. And then just seeing how this side feels. Time just to relax and stretch.
God's still here. That's something beautiful.
Just let that breath slide in your chest. Look at the belly drops towards the floor as you inhale. Exhale, releasing everything that's tense in the body. Inhale, reach that left arm up, and exhale, down. And just find that child's pose again that works for your body. Maybe use a little bit wider. Just settling in and resting. And then soften your lips closer towards the heels. And when you're ready, slowly lifting up with the inhale. Bring the hands underneath the shoulders and the knees underneath the hips. And just breathe here. Find that neutral position where your spine is comfortably straight. Shoulders are rolled back and down. Have a nice strong base to work from. And then just feel the pressure in the hands. Are you pressing evenly through all the fingertips? Feeling those knuckles pressing towards the mat. And finally the palms. Belly button is engaged, and now we're going to inhale, breathe up, letting the belly button drop towards the floor, and letting the belly relax. And when you're ready, just lift that head slightly up, and then exhale, reverse that, so rounding the back, and letting that head just softly drop towards the floor. Again, just moving through cat and cow at your pace. So about 4 or 5 breaths here. We're starting to find some movement for our spine. So we want it to be smooth and gentle. Inhaling, letting that belly soften. Exhale, rounding the back. Bring the head drop. One more time through, inhaling. And then exhaling. And then finding your neutral position again. Belly button is tight. We're going to tuck those toes under. And take our first press back into down dog. So feel those hips lift. Make sure that there's still pressure through the whole hand, not just in the heel of the hand. And start to just alternate those heels up and down. See how those hamstrings are feeling this morning, the calves, the shoulders. If you want a little bit more movement through the spine, you can just take a little twist here. We're going to see where this thing goes. Come back to neutral. Brace the core, bend your knees, and then slowly walk those feet forward. We come to forward fold, so knees bent, core is engaged. And let's just take a little pressure out of the hands. Really let the spine get a beautiful stretch here. And you might need to nod yes or no to relax the neck. So just find that initial forward fold. Belly button is tight. High gaze lifts up, and we're gonna inhale, bringing the hands to the shins and flattening our back. So pull those elbows in. Long, straight spine. Belly button is tight. Exhale and fold. Release that weight out of the hands. And if you just need a little bit more, opposite hand to elbow, the ragdoll. Knees can be slightly bent. If you have a block and you feel like reaching the floor isn't comfortable, just put that block under your hand. Let's inhale to that flat back. Elbows pulling in, long, strong spine. And then an exhale, we're going to start to move and flow. Inhale, roll up slowly to standing.
squeezing glutes as we inhale and reach all the way up. Now exhale, open the palms to me. Squeeze the glutes and just let those arms start to open nice and wide. Taking those elbows wide, pulling the shoulders back and down. Inhale up. Exhale, hands come together and roll through the center line. Nice and slow and smooth. Exhaling, finding forward fold, and inhaling up to flat back. Exhaling again to forward fold. Knees can bend as needed, and then roll it all the way up. Make sure you're still squeezing the glutes. Inhaling, lifting. Palms open, knees squeeze, and inhale back. And then exhale, opening those elbows wide. Inhale up. And exhale to fold. And we're going to add on. So give me that half lift. And exhale. Hands come down. Step both feet back. And come into your plank. Now, knees can be up if you want, or feel free to let them drop to the floor, but still strong engagement in the back. Everybody slowly lowers to the floor, elbows in tight. When you get halfway, give me a little hold here. Feel that work. And then belly to the floor. Squeeze the shoulders back. And we just come to a baby cobra. So I gaze, just looking forward slightly. Glutes squeezed. Toes tuck under. We exhale and come back to our down dog. And we walk the feet forward. Knees bend as needed. And then we inhale, squeezing all the way up. Exhale, open those arms, squeeze the bum, and let the elbows drop wide. Inhale up. And exhale, folding. And down. Inhale to flat back. And exhale to fold. Take those feet back. And find your plank again. Knees up or down, you choose. But squeeze those elbows in tight. And then we lower. Bracing the core, keeping the back flat. Releasing to the floor and squeezing shoulder blades, lifting maybe just a little bit more on that second tendon, top toes, and exhale back to the down dog. Slowly march those feet forward to that forward fold. Engage the core, big, beautiful breath all the way up, reaching higher. And exhale, open, squeezing those elbows down, shoulder blades squeeze into the spine. Inhale all the way up, and we exhale. Coming to that forward fold, and this time stepping back into down dog. And we're gonna get some hip openers here. Spread those fingers wide, brace the core. Lift that right leg up behind you, flexing that foot, really feeling that heel reaching. And bend that knee. Relax, and if you want, if you roll that ankle, maybe reach just a little bit more hip opening. And you roll. Maybe try both ways, see what feels better. Let's extend that leg long and straight, and release it down. And then pedal the feet. Brace that core. Settle the feet again. Inhale, left leg lifts up. Long and straight. Bending that knee. Letting that hip open. And then deciding what feels good. Maybe you're like me and that ankle is doing a little bit of cracking today. Just be gentle. Let's listen to our bodies. Try that other direction. And extend, big inhale. And then let that foot come down. Gently walk the feet in. Let's take a little inhale to that flat back. Exhale. And then a big breath all the way up. Open the arms. Inhale and then open elbows. Exhaling, finding that cactus pose. And then releasing. Take your left foot forward, right foot back. And we want to angle that right foot so that we can comfortably shift our hips forward. Let that front knee bend in just over the ankle. We're engaging our glutes and we're inhaling all the way up. Good. Now if you want, you can squeeze and do just a little reach back here. It's up to you. But feel that pressure evenly into the feet. Brace your core. We're going to lean forward, linking those hands behind, keeping the chest strong. A little stretch if that feels good for you, or you can just keep hands down. But let's inhale up. Lifting those hands up towards the sky, and then rotating forward again. Squeeze, keep that core engaged. You're pressing into that forward foot. And then inhaling all the way up. Brace the core, hands to the thighs, step in, and then change legs. So knee bent over the ankle, hips rotated forward. Big inhale up, and exhale, just sink into those legs. Do you want to squeeze a little tighter and just open that chest? Find that warmth in the legs. Before we start to stretch and get into our deeper stretches, we're going to warm those muscles up. Good, extend. Chest is lifting, core is tight. Inhale, breathe in. Press into that right front foot. And again, engaging breathing. Inhaling all the way up, and then exhaling, hands come forward all the way to the floor. Drop that back knee, and we find a kneeling lunge. Now I want you to try to shift those hips comfortably forward. We want that knee above or behind the ankle. So if you're tucked under like this, I want you to take that back leg back a little farther until we can get that front knee above or behind the ankle. So we're not putting a lot of pressure on that front knee. Now belly button is tight. We're going to shift the hips back and let this front toe lift. And your front leg can be straight or slightly bent. You want to feel that stretch through those hamstrings. And then decide if you want to let that head just slowly drop. Nice and gentle. Belly button is tight. Shift it forward. Hips relax. You might even walk that front foot out and take a hand inside. Just see if that feels better for your body today. Takes a little pressure out of my upper body and allows my hips to sink in a little bit deeper. Now we've got the option, we can shift right back where we were before, here, or if you're wanting to just see where splits are, you don't have to go all the way down, but we might just decide to see how we're feeling today. I'm feeling super tight today. So if you're with me, be patient with your body. Just because you could do it yesterday doesn't mean your body wants to do it today. Good, belly button is tight. No matter which pose you went to, let's ease back And we're going to open those knees and just sink back into child's pose for a moment. Let everything catch a little break. Shift a little side to side, helping to loosen those hips and relaxing. And then belly button is tight. Shift the hips forward and we get the other leg. So just help that leg forward. Again, we want the front leg to have the knee above the ankle or slightly behind it, not past it. So we're just letting those hips sink deeper. Hopefully you can't get enough of these hip openers. Nice big stretches here. Let's shift those hips back. Bracing the core. Exhaling, letting it relax. Front toes lifting. Feel that beautiful stretch through the front hamstrings. Let's shift it forward. And again, if you want, you might take that hand inside that front leg and just walk it out slightly so that you really can sink in. All right, you decide, where do you want to go? Back to splits or shifting back again here? You might find that one side's a little better than the other. Just stretch each side where it needs to be for today. Belly button is tight now. Shift those hips off to the side and bend that front leg. Should be your left leg. And you've got a couple options here. We can find 90-90, so both legs 90 degrees. Shifting the hips to face the front of the room. I'm turned to the side so that you can see those lunges a little bit differently. So you can move here. If you have the desire, you might decide to roll that hip up and over and straighten that back leg. Either way, we're all focused on trying to square the hips and shoulders, so we're looking straight ahead. If you're still facing the front, stay there. I'm going to pivot back around. All right, now, hopefully I'm back on with you guys the same way. Let's walk our hands over to your left side and then ease down, letting the chest rest towards the leg. It may or may not get there, that's all right. If you're a 90-90, you're gonna be up a little higher than I am. I'm gonna see if I can ease down a little bit. If you want to join me, feel free. Letting that head rest towards the floor. And then let's just see if we can roll that right hip over our left heel. You should feel a deeper stretch in the outside of that left glute. We're going to brace our core and take those hands back by that front knee. And then big inhale as we lift and shift back here to the front. Now, if you're in 90-90, you're going to find a quad stretch if it's comfortable. So you're reaching back. You can do the same thing if you're in swan pose. Right here, reach back. So whichever one you want. We're just trying to get a little deeper stretch into that back quadricep. Now, if you're in swan and you want to extend that swan, feel free. Trying to keep the mic from speaking. So you could rest your head down. And then we softly release. Brace the core. You can push back to down dog. And then come right back in with the other foot in front this time. So that might slide you right into swan. Or you might come back here to 90-90. Either way, we're all turning hips and shoulders to the front and leaning it's comfortable. All right, let's walk it over, this time to the right side. Since that right leg is forward, and just ease it down. Bracing the core, deciding where you want to go with those arms. And then shifting that left hip right over the right heel. And then trying to relax those legs towards the floor. With that next inhale, hands come back towards that front knee. Inhale, lift up. Re-square the body towards the front. Decide if you want to go for that quad stretch. And relax into it. Ooh, this is my tight side. So just see where you can go with that today. Maybe you want to ease down a little bit. Soften the hips. Belly button is tight. Softly release that foot. And press hands underneath shoulders. Brace the core and push back to that down dog. And let's pedal those legs. Just let them relax. And then keep the belly engaged. We're going to walk those feet forward. And then we're going to walk the feet nice and wide. So as wide as you can comfortably get them, spreading the weight evenly through all the feet. And we come into this wide leg forward fold. So slowly lower the upper body. And again, if you have a block, you might place that here. Maybe you want to just rest your head. But we're keeping that belly button engaged so our lower back has some support. And we're just slowly releasing wherever our body needs it to be. Good, just inhale, lift up, taking that head above the heart level. So if you just need a little time to breathe here, that's fine. If you still want to stay down and find that deeper stretch, that's okay too. We've got about 3 more breaths here. If you're looking for an even deeper stretch, you might reach those hands through. One more breath cycle here. And then inhale, everybody walks their hands forward, bracing the core. We're going to take the heel and toe in a couple times. Hands still supporting us. Toes slightly turned out. And you're going to slowly let those hips lower. And you're just going to stop them where they need to go. Adjust the feet as needed. We're getting a big hip opener here. If it feels comfortable, you're going to ease those hips all the way down. So you might find any of those positions. Or you might decide to shift all the way back. Use those hands to help press those elbows into the inner thighs. Strong spine. Belly button is tight. And then we release hands to the floor. Forward. Tuck the knees down, coming to horse stance. Knees are wide. And belly button is tight. Let's shift it back. Find child's pose again. Just take a little breather here. everything softens again. Belly button is tight. We inhale and we lift up. And we're going to have a seat. And we're going to take the legs in front. So you might need to make a little adjustment so those sits bones are anchored into the floor. Take your left leg and you can put it right here, or if it's comfortable and those sits bones stay anchored, you might take it over the other leg. So you're going to hug that left leg in with your right arm. And then that left arm is going to come back, just the fingertips on the floor, so we can inhale, lengthen that spine, and hug that leg in close. Now, if you want a little more spinal twist, you're going to inhale, lengthen the spine a bit more, and exhale, turn the eye gaze over towards that left shoulder. And then just see, you want to lift that left arm up, taking the eye gaze back to that left hand. And if you want a little bit more, slide that right hand down to the outside of the left foot and just press that heel forward, straightening the leg as much as you want. And then you can use that right hand to press into that leg to deepen the twist. Just a breath here. And then we release, switching sides. So nice and straight to begin with. Right leg up or right leg over. Hug it in close. Nice tight hug for our leg. Right fingertips back to the ground. First, find that lengthening of the spine, creating space for it to move. Relaxing the shoulders and then inhaling, straightening a little bit more, and exhaling as we take that eye gaze towards the right shoulder this time. Hugging that leg close, sitting tall. Do you want to inhale that right arm back up? Exhale, let the shoulders relax. Keep the length in the spine. And if you want, hand down to the foot with that extension. And then maybe even a bigger press into that foot to find that deep twist. One inhale and exhale here. Very nice. And we release it down. We're going to take the legs wide, and if you need to, shift those hips back slightly so you can sit up nice and tall. So we don't want to be rounded over. We want to rotate that pelvis so we're leaning in and ready to stretch our legs and our spines. All right, let's take an inhale all the way up. Exhale, let those shoulders relax. And then I want you to inhale the spine up just a little farther. And exhale, right arm tucks under, left arm reaches over. Legs are relaxing. And then inhale up. Both arms reach up. Exhale. And then we find the other side. So that big inhale in the center is to lengthen the spine, allowing the space in between each bone so that we can really find that side bend. And inhale up again. And exhale. All right, this time, big inhale, reach up. And we're gonna turn towards that right foot. And just exhale, reaching forward, hands resting on the floor. Keep the hips and shoulders turned towards that right side. And just let everything relax. Inhale, reach up. And exhale, turning to the other side. Exhaling and releasing. Keeping both of the sits bones onto the floor. Anchoring our bodies. And then inhaling all the way up. Brace that core. Let's flex our feet. Squeeze the quadriceps up like you're pulling those knees closer to the hips. And then exhale. Big reach forward until your body says that's enough. And then hands rest to the floor. Feet, legs relax as the upper body just rolls for that forward fold. Just relax here. Inhale, breathe in. Exhale, soften the body. Inhale. Walk those hands back. We're going to take the feet over to this direction. So help those legs in. And we're going to roll back. So just shift the hips wherever it's comfortable. And roll down slowly, bracing the core, letting the spine release. When your spine is comfortable, brace your core and bring the knees in towards the chest. And you might just roll side to side. Belly button stays engaged just to support our lower back while we're here. Now embrace the core. We're going to extend the right leg nice and long. Let it relax towards the floor. And then when you're ready, begin to extend that left leg. Hands can link anywhere. We find this nice big hamstring stretch. Let's try to relax the shoulders back. And just have a little opportunity to see if flexing makes it feel better. Or just do a little too much. So a little back and forth. It's a nice big hamstring stretch. You can hold both places. If you want to grab a hold of the ball of your feet for that deeper stretch, that's fine. Belly button is tight. Just bend that left knee. Pull the right knee in. And we switch sides. Let it release. And when you're settled, inhale, stretching that leg up, finding that initial stretch. And then just softening the body. The arms relax and just a little. Play back and forth with the pointing and the flexing. Adjust the hands as needed. Feel that beautiful stretch. Back of the leg and front of the shin. And then pull those knees in. You again can just rock a little side to side, or maybe you make some circles. If you're circling, reverse it, get a couple circles the other direction. And then brace your core. We're going to take the arms out wide and set the feet down. Just make sure your spine is straight here. Let's take the right leg up and over the left leg. Now we're going to press into that left foot, lifting the hips and shifting them slightly to that right side and settling them back down. Now brace your core tight. Let's inhale and exhale. Just let those legs slowly move to the left side of the body. We might not make it to the floor. That's okay. This is a pretty intense twist. So just find that initial spot where you can take inventory of whether or not you should go farther. If you feel like you've got a little bit more room to twist, brace the core and just see if you can relax the legs a little farther. This is one where we just want to be safe, really be aware of what our body is telling us. And if you need just a smidgen more, take that left hand on top of that right leg. Just let it rest there. That's going to apply enough pressure. Can you soften the shoulders towards the mat? Letting the hips soften and relax. Hand rock if you placed it there. Really tight bracing of the core. Inhale, lift the legs up to center. Don't unlink the legs just yet. Pick your hips up and straighten the spine again. If you need to, adjust where your shoulders are so your spine feels long and stretched. And then we brace the core and we move our legs over to that right side. So they're still linked. And we're just heading the other direction. And we're feeling a deep stretch all the way through the side of our body. Just relaxing the shoulders back. Brace the core. Let's see if you want to release just a little farther. Belly button is tight. Brace, pull those legs back up to center. This time, take that right leg off. And we use this time just to straighten that spine again. So lift and unravel that spine. And then we come to the other side. Left leg up and over the right. Brace your core, press into that right heel. Lift the hips up, set them to the left side slightly. And then allow those legs to move over to the right side. That shifting of the hips allows the spine and hip bones to stay in alignment as we find this spiral twist. Shoulders relaxing. Belly button still engaged so that our lower back is safe. And do you want to take that free hand up to that left leg, just resting. Relax in the shoulders. And belly button's tight. Brace the core, take the hand off, lift the knees up. Remember, keep the legs linked. Lift the hips up, straighten the spine. So nice long spine here. And when you're ready, brace the core and let those legs shift to the other side. This is my hard side. Lots of surgeries make it not as flexible. So if you have some issues, just be patient with your body. We work with what we have. See where you can go today. Belly button's tight. Brace that core. And take those legs back up to center. Unravel the legs. Brace the core. We're going to lift those hips, lengthen the spine, and then let it settle down. Take the soles of the feet together. So you want to feel the heels close to the bum, wherever you can get them. And then the soles of the feet press, but the knees open wide. And we're just letting those knees open naturally, wherever they might fall. And then we're going to extend our warrior, our butterfly. So opposite hand to elbow. Big inhale all the way up. And exhale, relax the shoulders back, relax the arms. Feel this beautiful stretch through the shoulders, the chest, hips. And we're just going to relax here. You can close your eyes. Let the mind and body settle. Be aware of each other. And focus on the body. And now we come back towards the beginning where we focused on the mind. Just enjoy the success. butterfly for a few more breaths. Belly button's tight. We're going to bring those arms up. Knees come together. And we just find our happy baby. This is going to be our last pose. So you might bring fingers to the toes, inside or outside of the foot, maybe even the heels or the inside of the thighs. You choose. Let those knees press towards the floor. Find that big stretch. And then let's try extending one leg at a time. Maybe both legs. And then gently bringing those legs back together. Knees just softly resting at the chest. And this is your chance to find any pose that feels good for you today. You might lay the arms out wide, palms up, and straighten those legs and just breathe here. Just take the next couple of breaths to get settled. Lying flat isn't what feels comfortable. Feel free to find a seated position. Slow that inhale through the nose. And exhale out through the open lips. Inhaling and exhaling, just seeing you need to change the body position. Take an inhale. We're going to squeeze every muscle of the body as tightly as we can. And then we're going to completely release that tension, allowing the body to relax. And then just breathe here. Coming back to our intention from class. Loving kindness to my body. So I just want to breathe in. Imagine that breath is warm and send it down the body. And just keep that mind focused on your intention. Inhaling. Acknowledging that intention. To accomplish what we needed to. And if other thoughts trickle in, it's okay. Just acknowledge them with the inhale and exhale, let them flow away. Back to the fingers and the toes. Letting your wrists roll. The ankles. And then just letting the body come to rest on the right side. So tucking those knees up. Letting the hands come underneath the head so that the spine is in proper alignment. and just breathing here for a few moments. When you're ready, slowly taking that top hand, pressing to lift slightly, putting that forearm down, take your time coming up. Just inhaling slowly, coming to any seated position. And let's take an inhale, lengthen the spine. Release the shoulders, and this time inhale all the way up, bringing those hands overhead, palms coming together, and exhaling, bringing the hands to our heart center. Thank you for sharing your time with me today. Namaste. Have a beautiful weekend. And remember that we are closed on Monday for the holiday. But there's lots of videos to do, so if you need a little workout,